corpse and how you can revive them. I have an old laptop that is not really being used, but I know somebody who can make use of it. But the problem is that the screen is flickering. So there are two things that are important with old laptops, how you can revive old laptops. One is that you can install a Linux operating system, which is free, and can revive any old computer. There are many Linux distributions for old computers, so even if you don't have a very powerful old laptop, you can even run it quite nicely if you just choose the right distribution. But today we will talk about how to fix flickering on an old laptop I have right here. The problem is that the screen is flickering, and when you see flickering like this, it means that in most cases that there is a loose connection. There is a connector just behind the screen and on the motherboard. After some time I figure out it's the motherboard that there is an error. And I don't think it's the cable, I think it's the connector. The connector itself needs to be soldered better on the motherboard. So either you can take out the whole motherboard and put it in an oven or something like that, some people do that, or you can use a heat gun just to warm it up and then press the unit where the connector is attached. So if you have a heat gun, that's good. I only have a soldering iron, so I'll try with a soldering iron today. We have the model number, it's G580, and I already enabled that we can open the access to the motherboard, which on this computer is behind the keyboard. And you can see this is the cable, and when you push it down here somewhere, the connector, yeah, then it just stops the flickering. Sometimes you can even put a coin inside and just press it here. But then the flickering stops. But right now we need to do some soldering here, or a heat gun, or maybe it's the connector itself that has become loose. Sometimes you can don't do this when the computer is on normally, because there can be some unexpected stuff. But yeah, sometimes you can just take it out and just insert it again. It's a really good idea to be grounded. Screen is working fine now. But then after a while, it's just like something, when it heats up, then something goes loose. So if you have like periodical errors and something goes loose, it's because it heats up and expands. And when it expands, there is a loose connection somewhere. And sometimes it's very, very hard to find the error. Could also be the defect on the motherboard itself. Nobody knows.
My setup, I have the soldering iron. I'm not sure about the temperature, not too hot. Maybe start with 400 degrees.
Just try to solder on the connectors here and then push on top of that one at the same time. There's this little plastic flap. I just taped it here so it will not, so I have this area free. With this one, I apply like pretty hard pressure. So in this case, it was actually the EDP cable, this one. I changed it to a spare one, which I ordered some time ago, and now the screen is working. And I can tap on this part, and the screen is still working. Okay, so in this case the EDP cable. Sometimes you can just replace the EDP cable and then you have a brand new computer.